The winner of today's fierce rivalry game will take home the Paul Bunyan Governor of Michigan Trophy. This coin toss presented by Nissan, innovation that excites. Michigan is lined up to kick the ball off first, and we are ready to go. He really got a hold of that kick. He's to the 20. And he's tackled at the 26. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. Brought down right around the 24-yard line. So the halfback loses about two on the run. From their own 24-yard line, it's second down.
Here we go!
Throws a strike over the middle. Tackle made at the 37-yard line.
Good job here by the receiver to look the ball in and ensure he had possession. That's the right way to catch a pass. That's not what you hope for from your running game. You're looking for some solid north and south progress. You never want to give the defense a play like that to build their confidence.
From their own 33-yard line, second down. They go to the screen here, the halfback's got it. They'll bring him down at the 37. Taken down right around the 44-yard line.
The quarterback did an excellent job of recognizing the Mike linebacker on the blitz. He hung in there, delivered the pass, and his receiver made a good catch to move the sticks.
From the 44-yard line, first down. Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. Tackle at about the 31. And a nice pickup there.
I'll tell you what, the defense gambled a bit here and came with the blitz, and a quarterback showed tremendous poise by making a good read and delivered a nice ball to the open man.
And he's tackled at about the 29-yard line. And this is the eighth play of the drive. Quickly, and he's got his man. He's tackled at the 29. Nothing going on that play.
Well, here I think the quarterback needs to be a little bit more patient in the pocket. That way he can allow his receivers to get downfield a little bit before he throws it.
It's third down, eight to go. Ball on the 29. Fumble. Offense falls on it. He's taken down at the 41.
And they will keep the drive alive by recovering their own fumble.
And the booth is going to take a few looks at this to see whether or not the ball came out before he was down. So the question here is whether or not his knee hit the ground before the ball came out. Well, after seeing the replay, it was apparent that his knee was down before he lost the ball.
Yep, those guys in the booth aren't perfect, but they got it right this time.
Looks like someone got a head start on the line.
Sometimes what happens on a false start is a lineman will see movement on the other side of the ball and be coaxed into jumping early.
Fourth down and a ways to go after the penalty.
The punter is going to try to pin them deep in their own territory with a good punt here.
This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
The Wolverines having a wide receiver like this, I think sometimes it even helps a young quarterback because this kid goes out there, he works hard in practice every day, and I think he really lifts the whole offense.
I think he does. I think he's almost like having an extension from the coaching staff into the locker room with the players. He's a guy that makes big plays, but I think he takes it upon himself to be able to help out with some of the other receivers, make sure that they're all on the same page, understand the route adjustments, understand everything that goes on with being a wide receiver and the importance of blocking. So all the little things that seem to add up and make big plays, I think this guy totally understands his responsibilities being a go-to player.
Caught, and he's hit immediately. The stop at the 28-yard line. That pass play went for nearly enough to keep moving, but they're stopped just short. Boy, that's tough.
That is always a tough pill to swallow. Having to leave the field, knowing how close you came to converting on third down. You gotta get those.
He makes it to the 45-yard line. There's a flag down, and it looks like this one's coming back. That one will put the offense in a hole, and they'll try to get some of that back on this upcoming play. It's first and 10. Ball on the 24-yard line. Run, 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 run. And down he goes at about the 27-yard line. Tackles him hard at the 29-yard line. 2-yard gain on the quarterback keeper. From their own 29-yard line, third down. He flings it left. Stays in bounds and made a nice catch.
This guy has that innate ability to get just enough distance from a defender to make a completion possible. You don't see it from every receiver, but this guy's got it.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 49-yard line. Pass complete and taken down immediately. It out in a hurry.
That's good decision making there and mechanics by the quarterback. He knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but he looked off the other receivers first.
From the 28-yard line, it's first down. Makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line. This is the eighth play of this drive. Set, line, line. Pass, pass.
and take him down immediately. Well, they'll line it up again on third down. Two for two so far on this drive. They try to get a head start there. They'll line up for another third down play because of the penalty.
Well, here you're in a third down situation, and then someone makes a mental mistake. It makes your blood boil if you're a coach.
Delivers to the halfback on the screen. And he's shoved out of bounds at about the 15-yard line.
Well, they're living on the edge here a little bit, but, you know, they're converting when they have to.
10th play of the drive.
Ready?
Quick out to his receiver. And that sets them up with a first and goal. First down. They've got the defense on their heels now. It's first and goal. The Wolverines had one of their key guys go down earlier, but it looks like he might be able to return. Loss of two on the run by the halfback. Here's the 12th play of the drive. Throwing left. Incomplete. Almost picked off.
This is a very well-coached defense. They know to get their hands up in the air and to try to knock down passes.
The defense has really held their own the last two plays. Now it's third and goal from the 7. Trying to set up a little screen. Gets it to his tailback. He gets hit out of bounds around the 8-yard line. Michigan State is looking to go up by 3. It's up, and it's good.
Even though they gave up a field goal here, that defense is feeling pretty good about themselves right now. It could have just as easily been a touchdown.
The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He's to the 20. They'll bring him down at the 29. Somebody hit the upset alert button because this one looks like it just might be heading in that direction. 3-0, Michigan State. And we welcome you back to the action here, and we have got a tight one going on in quarter number 2. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Wants to go long and does. Brought down around the 29-yard line.
Nice play. Good job here by the quarterback is staying with his receiver, and the receiver stays with the route because he knows his quarterback has the arm strength to get it there.
Catches it, and that's all. And he's hit before he can go anywhere. It's complete for about 7 yards and a first down.
And how about the poise of this quarterback to locate his receiver past the sticks and get him the ball? That was a great throw.
Catches it, and he's punished. Across the middle to his tight end. Big play there, and now they're looking at first and goal. Fires a laser touchdown. They call it a catch, but the booth signaled down to the referee that they'd like to take another peek at this.
Man, as I see this play again, it really looks like he made the correct call on the field.
The
The ruling on the field will stand. He caught it.
The only thing left to say about this play is that was an excellent catch.
And he tacks on the extra point.
It was a 6-play, 72-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points.
You know, Brad, a lot of times you have to watch practice and watch a 7-on-7 drill and not see the ball touch the ground. This time, they went the entire length of the field. The ball never touched the ground. Great execution by the quarterback and the receiver.
It's fielded at the 2. Oh, he got nailed on that one.
There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes.
Ready,
they go with the run, and he's taken down behind the line. Loss of one there for the halfback. From their own 27-yard line, it's second down. They'll get him for a loss. Loss of 2 by the halfback. They'll line up with 5 wide receivers. Got it. And he goes down quickly. Nation's top talents really struggling in this one today. Collins' big playability was supposed to be on display, and yet he's trying to find any kind of rhythm. And we've seen the team rally around him, though, and they got the lead.
Yeah, and Brad, this defense has done just a great job of being able to take him out of this game today. They've been able to really just limit his touches, and yet for some reason they still find themselves trailing in this game. I think it's a good example of how one player can alter a defensive game plan and really puts this defense in a position where they're going to have to make some adjustments here and try to put more pressure on this team and get the ball back to their own offense.
Fires to his tight end, nothing doing.
Pretty good effort here by the quarterback of trying to squeeze that ball into a tight spot. I know it was incomplete, but he didn't have too many other options.
It's third down, and they're about the length of the football away from the first down marker. He's hit and taken down. Michigan holds a 4-point lead. They hand it off. He makes it out to maybe the 46-yard line. Up the middle for a nice game. Decent run here, right side.
Two times. Five.
Another run. They'll knock him down for a loss. Screen pass, gets it to the back, and they push him out at the 30. They've looked good so far on third down in this drive. Let's see what happens here. Here's the halfback on the screen, knocked out of bounds at the 24. Pass. Tackle made at the 17.
Hey, left.
he's stopped behind the line.
The offense knows that the linebackers are cheating up a little bit on the run. If they can get some protection, they might want to open up a little bit of space for some passes underneath.
This is the 12th play of this drive. Michigan is up by four.
Here we go.
Quick strike, and it's caught for the touchdown. The PAT. So a 12-play, 66-yard drive, and a touchdown as a result.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
So our score, 14-3. Reed fields it at the 2. He's taken down at the 27. We're about set to start things up again. Play gets him a yard at the most.
This young wide receiver has the raw ability to make some big plays. So that was a good job there by the defense to stop him for a short game.
From their own 28-yard line, it's second down. Bring him down right around the 46-yard line.
Let's give some credit to the big boys up front. They held off the blitz just long enough for the quarterback to make the connection and pick up some good yards.
On the hand, a big hit, and he'll lose yardage. We've got a second and 14. Ball on the 49-yard line. Tackled after a decent run up the gut. Collins comes away with 5 yards on the carry. Receiver flew down the field on that touchdown connection.
Well, he has the speed to stretch the defense, and his hands are getting better every single game.
It was a pretty simple route, but they run it to perfection for the score. And he adds the extra point. A 5-play, 73-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
So the score now, 14-10. He gets out to about the 25-yard line. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Michigan is up 4. Flips it middle to the running back. And he's level at the 30-yard line. A pickup of 5.
Not a bad play. They gain 5 yards out of it, and they keep moving the defense back.
Second down and 5. Ball on the 30. Throws to the receiver. Incomplete. Snags that one. And he's tackled around the 48-yard line. Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 48-yard line. At the 25-yard line. Tries to scramble, but he's sacked. Michigan holds a four-point lead. Fires out quick. It's picked off. Sheds that one.
It looked like the pass was sailing out of reach, but he just climbed the ladder and made a spectacular interception.
From their own 38-yard line. First down. Got it and brought down immediately. Michigan State's going to use their first time out of the half here. Once and all, going deep. He goes up. Picked off. Missed tackle.
He seemed a little hesitant on that throw, and that left the defender time to break on the ball and pick it off.
From their own 33-yard line, it's first down. Out of bounds at about the 37-yard line. Michigan is up by four. Throws incomplete, intended for his wideouts. Third and six. Ball on their own 37. Crosses out to the tailback on the screen. He steps out around the 41-yard line. Hart awaits the snap. He makes it to the 28-yard line. Their last drive ended with an interception. We're about to find out what the defense can do this time.
And I don't think this defense will lay down lightly. They're going to try to continue to rattle this guy.
And down he goes, around the 30-yard line. We've still got a half of football remaining. Michigan's up by four.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. Defense has been in total control in the first half, and you'd think maybe the offense's confidence was shaken. But if you want to look at the entire team picture, David, how big a deal is it for an offense to know, look, if we can just put together one, maybe two good scoring drives, our defense has got our back?
Well, a lot of times when you know you have a defense, it's great, too, is you build your offense around it. And when I say that, why do I need to take chances? You know, if it's third and long, I don't mind throwing a five-yard pass, and if I break a tackle, I get a first down. I mean, don't put my defense that's dominant, that's great, in a bad position, and you can afford to be more conservative. You see it every single year. What do we always talk about here at ESPN? We talk about you defense wins championships, and that's how you win ball games, and you see it consistently unfold. So if I'm building an offense, let's just not put my great dominant defense in a bad position.
That's going to do it for David and me here in the studio. Time to get you back to the game. Brad and Kirk ready to take you home in the second half.
Great first half and a tight ball game, and we're set to start quarter number three. He'll return it from the one. And he's tackled at the 27-yard line. So now both teams come trotting back out onto the field. Michigan is up four. Nice run there. Taken down at the 39. Gains his way to the 49-yard line. Slings it. Brought down at the 46. Taken back a yard.
Really, they just had nowhere to go after the catch.
Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 41.
Tight right, tight right.
Three down, three down.
Quick throw out to the receiver. And they make the stop around the 35-yard line. They try to get a head start there. Well, that penalty drives them back, and they're shooting themselves in the foot here.
Well, if they could just keep their concentration, they'll avoid situations like that.
First and 15 now after the penalty. Throws this one away. And this is the eighth play of the drive. Michigan holds a four-point lead. Got his man. Oh, what a hit. Kirk, that was a nice grab there.
You know, it may be simple, but whenever you can gain solid yardage, you're doing something right.
Throws complete. He's got space to work. He's taken down at about the 7-yard line. He fights forward to about the 7. And the defense gives up some free yards to the offense.
You know, penalties can ruin a team's chances to win if they commit too many.
First and goal from the 3. They're knocking on the door.
Here we go. White, 80. White.
The cavalry's coming. And he's going to run this one in. Touchdown. They
weren't able to defend a quarterback scramble, and they give up six.
And he's one of those quarterbacks who can do this when he's close to the goal line. He'll pump fake, then take off, or he'll put his head down and crash it in. Anything goes with this guy.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He's to the 20. Tackle made at the 26. There's a flag down, and it looks like this one's coming back. That one will put the offense in a hole, and they'll try to get some of that back on this upcoming play.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game.
He is drilled at the 14-yard line, and he gets a yard on the run.
One thing the coaches always say about this sophomore is that he has great lateral movement. That lets him move well behind this defensive line and get after a lot of plays in the running game.
Fires it out. He's tackled around the 18-yard line. From their own 18-yard line, third down.
Set, green and five! Green and five!
Quick strike to the back, no good. Now it's going to be fourth down.
Nice defense. That was picture-perfect three and out. Good series for these guys.
This is a great punt-blocking team, and it looks like they're going to try to get to this one.
And he has it on the corner. They'll bring him down at the 43-yard line. The offense was able to punch it in the end zone on that last drive. They'll come back out looking for more of the same.
You can bet this defense made some adjustments on the sideline, though. I don't know if they can stop the passing attack, but they need to at least be able to slow it down.
He throws left. Tackle made at the 16. Pitches back, knocked out of bounds around the 15-yard line. From the 15-yard line, second down. He gets out to about the 15-yard line. It and it falls incomplete.
Good effort there by the receiver, but just not enough room for him to get a foot down in bounds.
So the kicking team is on the field. They'll try for three. The Spartans linemen come off the field with an injury. Doesn't appear to be too serious, though, so we might see him back in this game. And it splits the uprights. Moody is lined up to kick this one off. He'll return it from the three. Brought down at the 28-yard line. The Wolverines continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
Their last drive broke down and they punted. What do they have in store this time out?
Down two possessions. This offense has to step up and capitalize on this possession.
Complete. He's got room. He's at midfield. They'll bring him down at the 37.
That's just a great call by the coordinator there, going to the air on first down.
Now it's first and 10 with a defense trying to regroup after giving up the big pass.
Here we go.
They'll go ground. He makes it out to maybe the 36-yard line. Throws it out and it falls incomplete. Third down and they need to get it to the 27. He goes out of bounds at the 29-yard line. It's up, looks long enough, and it's good. Michigan State to kick. He'll take it from the two. And he's taken down at the 32-yard line. Flag on the play. Let's see what it is. Flipping is the call, and now they'll have to find a way to make up those yards right here. Well, the last drive was good for three, but I'm sure in this one they'll be looking to double that. Throws complete, and he stopped immediately. Tackled at about the 29-yard line. There's a strike complete. Tackle at the 32. From their own 32-yard line, it's third down.
Three down, three down.
Check four, check four.
Pressure coming. And he's level at the 43. There to stop him. Now he tries to buy some time. And down he goes at the 47-yard line.
Sometimes what happens on a false start is a lineman will see movement on the other side of the ball and be coaxed into jumping early.
So the penalty will make it first and 15.
Ready! Red 18!
And it's caught, and he's brought down quickly. Eubanks gained 7 yards with a catch there. Got his receiver again. Pitches back. That's a great tackle at the 40-yard line.
That's got to be very frustrating for that running back. This offense is trying to get in sync and trying to get a rhythm established, and for such a negative play to happen, loss of yards, that can really have a negative impact on the offense and what they're trying to do.
So it's fourth down. They'll call on the field goal unit. There's a little bit of happy feet down there on the field. Let's get the call.
Just a mental lapse, but it's going to cost them 5 yards.
Little too much leg into that punt. They'll bring it out to the 20. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game.
Set, 10, 19, cut.
Throws it to the outside. Oh, he had a shot at the pick. He was that close to making a big play.
His safety is kicking himself for dropping that one.
It's second and 10. Ball on the 20-yard line. Throw, and he's taken down at the 38-yard line. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 38. Well, this turned out to be a pretty good ball game, and we've got one quarter to go. 24-13, Michigan. All right, we're just about set to start action here again in the fourth quarter. Play action under pressure. He's got the corner, and they get the sack. Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 38-yard line. He's under pressure. Throws it deep. And this one's going to get intercepted. So the turnover will once again give the ball back to this offense.
That's two interceptions today by this defense. Their coach has to be happy that they're forcing turnovers.
From their own 13-yard line. First down. Airing it out long. And he hauls in the deep pass. To the 20, to the 10. Touchdown, Michigan.
This offense just has so many weapons to defend. They've got some genuine playmakers.
Converts the extra point. Michigan ready to kick this one off. He's to the 20. And he's tackled at the 28. They threw a pick the last time out. Should be interesting to see what they do this time.
The first rule on offense is to take care of the football. These guys need to remember that on this drive.
Got a man complete, and he's hit hard. It's second down, 6 to go. Ball on their own 32. Here's the halfback on the screen. Brought down around the 33-yard line. looks like he flinched down there on the line. They'll give this one another try after the flag.
And on third down, too. That's when you don't want those kind of things to happen.
Third down and 11 coming up here.
Ball on their own 28.
Here we go!
Tosses out to the tailback on the screen. He's pushed out of bounds.
Right around the 32-yard line.
Intercepted. Here's an opening down the sideline, and they make the stop
right around the 8-yard line. First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line.
Taken down at the 7. A 1-yard gain by the halfback. Steps out of bounds.
Around the 6-yard line.
Fourth down. This should be an easy field goal. Kicks away, and they tack on 3 points. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He sends this one deep. He's to the 20, and down he goes at the 25.
The quarterback comes back on the field, and I'm sure he's hoping to make up for that interception on the last drive.
This quarterback can make good passes. He just needs to focus on not forcing the ball to his receivers.
Looks like someone got a head start on the line.
Maybe he got the cadence wrong coming out of the huddle. The coaches have a low threshold for mistakes like that.
First and 15 now after the penalty. Stopped in his tracks with that tackle. Nothing going on that play.
Well, here I think the quarterback needs to be a little bit more patient in the pocket. That way he can allow his receivers to get downfield a little bit before he throws it.
Set. Green nine.
Out of bounds.
Around the 32-yard line.
So they're going to try to determine if the receiver had possession and was inbounds or not. So the referee initially calls it a catch, but we'll get a second look at it here and determine if he was inbounds when he hauled it in.
And that play happened so fast that it was very tough to tell if he was able to get a foot down or not.
The ruling on the field will stand. He caught it.
The only thing left to say about this play is that was an excellent catch.
Third down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down.
Ready! Red 18! Red 18!
He's to the 40. He's tackled
around the 44-yard line.
Passes it, and it's picked off by the safety. Tackle made at about the 45. He came up with a fantastic interception there.
Well, you know the quarterback is kicking himself for that one. He just made the wrong read.
First and 10. Ball on the 45. sack for a loss. Receiver, and they push him out at about the 41.
Man left, man left. Three down.
Throws it to the halfback on the screen. They'll bring him down at the 32-yard line. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 32-yard line. Less than 3 minutes in the game.
Set. Green 19. Green.
Makes it to the 24. The ball. They'll drop him for a loss. A loss on that one as he couldn't get past those big linemen.
You got that right. They sacrificed their bodies in there and stuffed him.
They need about 3 yards to get the first down here on third down. Tackles him hard at the 18. From the 18-yard line, first down. Nice run up the middle. We're at play number 9 of this current drive. This one's all but wrapped up. The Wolverines with the victory, 34-13. Let's get Kirk Herbstreit's final thoughts on this one. Herbie, what do you got for us?
Michigan came out here today and played with the heart and intensity that you love to see in a rivalry game. They should be very proud of their victory because wins don't come easy between these two teams.
For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next time.